was the distinctive penmanship of the guardian due to his being left-handed? Yes. Shoghi Effendi was left-handed in everything but his handwriting. And that was undoubtedly because he went to school, to a Jesuit school, very rigid, very strict, and they forced all the students, because I went to similar schools, use your right hand. So Shoghi Effendi used his right hand when writing. Everything else was left. And the fact that our friend has succeeded in arriving at this conclusion is really remarkable. I congratulate you. Please tell one story about being in the presence of Shoghi Effendi. I'm so glad it says one story. I was on pilgrimage in 1957, and January 1957, the very year that Shoghi Effendi passed away. And there were six of us, in that particular group. In those days, it wasn't 350 and 400 believers in each group. There were very few. And so we had been in Baji in the morning and became in the afternoon. And then we saw that Shoghi Effendi was in the gardens, and he signaled to us to join him. So we were in the pilgrim house. We ran to reach him as he was walking in the gardens near the shrine of the Baal. And one of us was an elderly gentleman. So when we arrived there, he started coughing. And because he was elderly, of course, those of us who were younger, like me, we stayed behind. All right. So when we arrived there and he was coughing, Shoghi Effendi stopped and turned in. He said, "You are tired." He answered, he said, "Beloved guardian, we were tired. Now that we are in your presence, all our fatigue has vanished." Boy, he did not like that. So he told him very lovingly, "Why did you say this?" This poor man did not know what to do, what to say. Believe me, if there was a hole there, he was ready to go into the hole and bury himself there. There was total silence. Then, with the same loving, tender tone, he said, "What you should have said was, we were tired, but now that we are in the precincts of the shrine of the Baal, all our fatigue has vanished. This is what you should have said." Then he added, "You did not come here to see me." God knows we were all there to see him, but never mind. Then, after a pause, he said, "You have come here to visit the shrines. The friends should not fix their gaze on individuals." I counted himself among individuals. That was the degree of his evanescence, his selflessness, his humility. Having said that, he turned his face and we followed. Did the guardian leave a will? Not in the regular sense, in the ordinary sense. No, he did not leave a will. And the hands have confirmed that they looked over the room of Shoghi Effendi, his office, his bedroom, everywhere. There was no sign of any will. And the hands have testified to this. But there is a letter written by Shoghi Effendi to Dr. Muschligel, Albert Muschligel. He was the hand of the cause in Germany. At that time, there was an idea in Germany, in the German Baha'i community, to publish a book which would be a compilation of the will and testament of Baha'u'llah, the will and testament of Abdul Baha. Because it was known to the Baha'is that Abdul Baha did not like to be in the same volume, in the same book as that of Baha'u'llah, distinction has to be made. So Dr. Mushagel wanted to see if this was proper, if it was appropriate. Answer of Shoghi Effendi. This was 1 year after he had written the dispensation of Baha'u'llah, which is one of the chapters of the book, The World Order of Baha'u'llah, compilation. He wrote back to Dr. Mushagel. He said, it's okay in this case, but I suggest that you also add to this book my own message to the American Baha'i community, published under the title of The Dispensation of Baha'u'llah. Because, and that is the important point, because it is an invaluable supplement to the will and testament of Abdul Baha and the will and testament of Baha'u'llah. So it will be three documents. He described his dispensation as a supplement, an annex, a supplement to what documents? Wills and testament. In other words, his dispensation was like a will and testament, because it's in the order of wills and testaments. It's all right, because it is an invaluable supplement. That is the closest we have. But to pilgrims, he had often said, I have written, and he used to refer even to Persian when he was speaking in Persian. He said, I have written the dispensation. It is like my will and testament. But these were all pilgrims' notes. Until the German National Spiritual Assembly published this compilation of letters addressed to members of its community, and this beautiful letter, written in 1935, 1 year after the dispensation was written. So the friends should be sure of two things: that he knew very well that he was not writing a will in the ordinary, regular way, and he did not want to write a will in that way. Second, the fact that he did not leave such a will does not mean that he died suddenly. He did not know that he was dying. There was no time for him to write a will. That's a fantasy. No, it's not so. There are so many evidences to show that Shoghi Effendi knew very well he was passing away. I remember during the interregnum, Janabi Samandari, hand of the cause of God, maybe some of you may have met Janabi Samandari. He used to tell the friends, beloved friends, this was during the interregnum, you should be well assured, he would say, that if Shoghi Effendi had any doubt about the security of the faith of Baha'u'llah after his passing, he would not have passed away. That was this man, like a rock. You can be sure that Mr. Samandari was right. What he said, his understanding was correct. And there are so many evidences, there's no time to mention other points.